I don't know about you, but this might get copyrighted. Today on this video, I'm going to teach you how I turn this into this. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Kytonic, and man, don't we have a good video today. Alright, this is something I've been wanting to show you guys. This is something that's like badass in every single fucking way, and it's called sound design, alright? If you don't know what sound design is, I'll break it down for you. Sound design is used by everyone and everything everywhere. It goes from music, to film, to gaming, to TV. Sound design is the sound of clicking a button. It feels right when you click the button because the sound matches and it's appropriate for it. Sound design is shaking up leaves and rustling them so that once you put them on a video of a rain, they sound like rain. So sound design is everywhere. We use it almost every day, and it's a very fundamental piece of what the entertainment industry is built up of. So today, I got something interesting for you. I'm a huge Star Trek fan, all right? Like, I love Star Trek. I'm very close to the Prime Timeline. The reboots are okay, you know? So, I was looking for something to do. I came up with this awesome project, and I thought, hey, I've seen Star Trek Into Darkness. I've seen a ship, you know, go at warp in title sequence over the main theme of the song. And I was like, hey, maybe I could design a sound for that. I started out by grabbing sounds off of YouTube, so like non-copyrighted sounds for monkeys and rustling and nature. You can tell my room's not soundproofed, okay? So what you're hearing is exactly what I got out of my microphone for these recordings. So it varies also on your location. It varies on the amount of sound, the amount of people in your house, the AC, where it is, if you put up a cover on the side of your bed like I do. But the biggest thing here is understanding that sound design is something that's supposed to feel right when you look at it. You're supposed to hear and associate what you see. It's the audio-visual connection that it creates. Before we get started, thank you guys for watching this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. The more interactions we get, the more views we get, the more everything we get, the more the channel gets upgraded, the more traffic we get, and the more we can grow. So please, guys, put the link down below, share it around with your friends. It only takes a few seconds. You have my eternal debt if you do that, honestly, like legit. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna dive into my laptop, right? This one right here. You guys will accompany me, and I'm just gonna try to show you guys what I did, kind of walk you through the project, and I'll show you guys the source sounds, where it came from. And yeah, guys, let's get into it. I'll see you then. Alright guys, so welcome to the new view. We're back here in the studio, as you can tell. Teaser pic on Instagram at Kytonic Official. You can check out, I don't know, I've been copying in videos lately. So here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna see the clip that I made in reference to the clip of Star Trek Into Darkness. After that, we're gonna base it off of what the real one sounds like, alright? So you guys can know back and forth. And then once that's done, we're gonna go into Ableton and we're gonna break it all down, and I'm gonna explain to you the creative process behind what sound designing is and how do you get into it. All right, I'll see you on the other side. Alright, with editing magic, welcome back. The first thing I did was that I grabbed a new soundtrack. So from the original soundtrack by Michael Giacchino. So this is the original up here. This is the entire thing, the yellow. It's called Video, right? This is where I got the reference to. So right now my biggest concern was the soundtrack. So I pulled the soundtrack from YouTube and I dragged it into here. I chopped it up. So I'm gonna show you where I spliced it. It's kind of strategic. I cut the music ending it, kind of putting it relative to what the actual frame is like. I'll show you guys right now. This movie was a great soundtrack. Alright, so that was the soundtrack. Alright, so now we're gonna dissect the sound design that I made. It's pretty self-explanatory. You can see what I use. It's really basic. I grabbed some stuff off of YouTube. Then I grabbed some recordings that I did of myself and things in my house. The leaf blower is me using this thing. It was a great reference. I needed something that could sound mechanical and whir at the same time, so that I could rev up without recording something like a car or something. So I grabbed one of these. These are one of the bed inflator things, but this is more for like a inflate a ball or something. This is what it sounds like, even though you heard it in the beginning. I'm just gonna play it for you guys. I also put my hand on top of it. That way it makes a forced rev rate. Like, it makes a forced rev. You can hear it. And in sound design, it's very important that you know where you place your microphone and everything. I could place this back here and it could sound a little bit muffled. I could place it over here and it sounds exactly how you're hearing right now. I could just put the air and all you hear is air. I did legit blow into my mic and you'll see that soon, but I could have, you know. Anyway, let's get back into it. Very first thing I did was this. I'll show you the first preset. I had to warp it. It's part of a, of course, when I recorded these samples, it wasn't just a short little clip. Okay, that's done. No, I recorded multiple takes into one audio file and I just kind of cut out what I thought was best. I'm going to turn off all the effects. You can hear just what it sounds like with the warp. That was the warp. It switches it out pretty funny. So yeah, that's exactly what it is. Then on top of that, we added some Valhalla reverb. Kind of soften it up, make it sound more like space. I used the Gemini default. I need something that I could just, you know, just kind of open up the space, make it a little bit more repetitive. There, as you can see, there's kind of a split here. And this was just more to kind of maintain the integrity of using the inflator. That's only because after I recorded this, the sonic boom was there, it was all into place, but we kind of lost the theme of the leaf blower and we kind of lost the sense that, like, you couldn't associate it was the same thing because you lost some of the sound that had made it. You understand that in a little bit as I show you, but that was the first sound that we did. So then we added some Valhalla and some grain delay and some utility. Utility is only to create the width. Grain delay, I modulated the pitch and frequency. And this is exactly what it sounds like right now. We have a second layer of that same thing. And this one's pretty straightforward as well. A lot of pitch, a lot of frequency here with the grain delay, utility, and then some more Gemini reverb. I pitched this one down 33 cents only because I liked the sound of the lower octave. But I didn't need something that was something exactly the same. I needed a specific type of low octave that would complement the higher one. So hear this one out. And as you can tell, if you combine them, you get a lot more depth than if you use just the one. Let's move on. And so the last layer is something of a voice. I don't know what to tell you about this one. I used vocoder on this one. I used pitch tracking. That's pretty much all I did. I just kind of changed the frequencies a little bit. I just need something that I could create an iconic whir, something that made the ship feel alive and not mechanical. Because usually science fiction things have this, had the tendency to look mechanical and sound real, and put together, this is what kind of completes the warp spaceship sound. And that's what sound design is about. So if you combine these three, you'll get a good feel of what it sounds like. And I'm pretty sure as you heard that. That's what we want to hear. We want to hear that sci-fi effect, but we want some mechanical grunge in there. On top of that, we added some garage AC. My dad has an office in the garage. That's where I used to record. And he had an AC, but it was one of those like window ACs that you kind of plug in. I basically just cut out the high end, give it that kind of a spaceship background engine type of feel. Even when you're on a cruise ship, you can feel the vibration, you can hear the engines rolling. And that's kind of where this came from. Like I said, spaceship ambience. Then we use some sub bass. Something simple is from this. It's from the True Urban. I think you guys have seen me use it in some of my videos. Kind of give it an aftershock effect. Then here comes the fun stuff. I blew into my microphone, and you'll see that video pop up when I play it. I definitely warped that a bit. That was pretty much it. As you can tell, there's no audio effects here. It's just me blowing into a microphone. What kind of completes the whole thing is the sonic boom. This is from an F-16. So as you can tell, the only big thing here is the EQ weight that I put on it, cutting out the low end. Considering I already have a sub bass and I have the I completely forgot about these. I had the stomp. Now we're moving on. And we're getting into the shakers. This is for the crystals that are left by the warp effect. I'll play them here. It's me shaking my Lego Star Wars set. Guys, I'm 18 and I still play with Legos. That's not a joke. So here, all I did was pretty much modulate the volume on all of them. Just played it with a pencil. I added some EQ weight, took out all of the lows and mids. All I wanted was the nitty gritty highs. And I added some reverb to soften it up. That's on the whole thing. Then I added some auto pan to go from left to right. And some chorus to thicken up the sound of the thin highs. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how we did the warp effect. So I'll play the warp effect for you guys without the music. Here's some good homemade sound design. So that's kind of my interpretation of it. I really felt that it didn't need to be so calm, so controlled. It is a ship, a hunk of metal blasting its way into another dimension. It has to sound grungy, otherworldly. It has to sound very mechanical, but alive at the same time. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like what you saw, please consider liking, subscribing, thumbs up. Please put a comment down below. What was your favorite part? What do you think I should do next? And any feedbacks or suggestions that you might have for my own good or your own good. The more traffic we get, the more likes we get, the more all of the above that we get, the more the channel grows. And honestly, guys, it's up to us to really take this further than we can possibly imagine. So thank you guys for being a part of the dream. Thank you guys for coming here. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Kytonic out.